What do you think is the best imaging modality for thyroid nodules?
Ultrasound scan?
Yes, ultrasound scan is the best imaging modality, first line and best imaging modality for the thyroid gland evaluation. So when we do ultrasound scan of the thyroid, 2/3 of the population will have some sort of nodule. So out of them, majority are benign. So I will teach you how to say whether they are benign or whether they are suspicious nodules. So this is how you see a thyroid gland when we do a ultrasound scan. So this is the normal contour. Can you see my cursor?
Yes, yes sir.
Right. So usually the ultrasound, thyroid gland is homogeneous. What's the meaning of homogeneous? Homogeneous
all
means
the same density.
That's right. Either density or echogenicity. So when it comes to ultrasound, they call it echogenicity, in echogenicity, like hypoechoic, isoechoic, and hyperechoic or anechoic. Likewise, in MRI, intensity, hypointense, isointense, and hyperintense. In CT and X-ray, density, hypodense, isodense, and hyperdense. So in ultrasound, it is normal ultrasound scan is homogeneous in echogenicity. Like this. Yeah. There are no specific changes according to the area. And the capsule is smooth and regular, like this. And this is a midline, so this is a smut, and the trachea. Trachea has fibro and cartilaginous tissues where the ultrasound won't traverse. So that's why it appears as a dark area. Laterally, you get carotid vessels. So don't misinterpret them as nodules. Always we can apply colored off lens. Hello? You can hear me, right?
Yes, sir. We can, sir.
Then, okay. Like the other day, I discussed about the BI-RADS classification for breast lesions. We have a heavy rain here. Background noise is high. Still, you can hear, no?
We can, sir.
Right. Like BI-RADS, for thyroid, we have BI-RADS classification. So, according to the composition, echogenicity, the shape, margin, and calcifications, we categorize. So when I say it's a TI-RADS 3 nodule, there is only a less than 5% of chance of getting malignancy. So usually we don't do appendices. But about TI-RADS 3, TI-RADS 4 or 5, we always go for cytology evaluation. So these are the categories. TI-RADS 1, we can ignore. TI-RADS 2, we can ignore. TI-RADS 3, we have to observe, but actually we don't do anything in FKR, at least for the protocols, right? But always we can do FNAC and confirm the benignity, or else we can observe it interval ultrasound scan. So, like I said, the composition, echogenicity, shape, margin, and calcification all get marks, points. I will discuss with some examples. So, the cumulative value gives this classification system. You don't have to memorize all these things. All you have to remember is there is a classification system which is a standard now. it has five categories like TI-RADS 1 to TI-RADS 5. When it comes to 5, until proven otherwise, it's a somatic condition. TI-RADS 1 is entirely benign, 2 is benign, 3 is probably benign, 4 is suspicious. Like in breast, TI-RADS 4 has 3 categories again, subcategories. 4A, 4B, and 4C, that is low suspicion for malignancy, moderate suspicion for malignancy, high suspicion for malignancy. Right. But there are exceptions for these classifications. For instance, in children, if you see a thyroid nodule in a child, you always further evaluate because it is unusual. Likewise, when we have a PET CT study, if you see any high uptake nodule in the thyroid, you do further evaluate. Likewise, when there is lymphadenopathy and any other known risk factors for thyroid malignancies like main type 2, then you don't go with the classification. Whenever there is a nodule, either you thoroughly observe or do thyroid. Right. Composition. This is the appearance of a cyst. So you don't have any signal inside. That is what you call anechoic. Anechoic. Anechoic means no signal. Okay. So trachea, so this is the left lobe, jugular vein, carotid, and a cyst. So a cyst is an entirely benign finding. No further evaluation is needed. Another benign nodule. This is what you call spongiform appearance. It's like a sponge. There are cystic areas and solid areas. So it's like a lace-like pattern. This is the other commonest, or rather, this is the commonest actually. Commonest nodules we see in our daily practice. So we can safely categorize this as TI-RADS 2 when we see this appearance. It has lace-like appearance with fluid and solid components. So spongiform nodules have a sponge-like appearance with at least 50% cystic composition of time. Composition, so no further evaluation is needed. Right. So there are certain nodules where it's a mixed pattern. It has fluid like the spongiform nodules, but this is not like spongiform, or this is not like a lace-like pattern. It is a pure nodule with large solid areas as well as large cystic areas. Again, these are features of benignity. You don't see malignant lesions like this. So I classify this again as a TI-RADS 3, probably benign nodule. So solid lesions, when it comes to solid lesions, now this is cystic and solid, this is spongiform. These are more solid. So this is entirely a solid lesion. And this is predominantly solid with few cystic areas, right? So when the solid component is high, it gets more marks, and according to the classification, it will be placed in a higher category. Right. Echogenicity is also important. So these are the nodules examples, okay? These are the surrounding thyroid parenchyma. This, here. So we always compare with the normal parenchyma. When the nodule is hyperechoic compared to the normal parenchyma. So this is called hyperechoic. And this is equal in echogenicity. So then it is, we call isoechoic. This one is hypoechoic compared to surrounding parenchyma. And here, we have surrounding rim calcification. So echogenicity is difficult to evaluate. You know why? The calcification won't allow ultrasound to travel. So anyway, it will be dark or hypoechoic light. So we can assess the echogenicity. Again, hypoechoic, isoechoic, hypoechoic. Right. This is a hypoechoic lesion. An example. Okay. Then comes the shape. Shape is a very strong predictor, like this says. The shape should be assessed in the axial plane. A taller than wide shape is a strong predictor of malignancy and therefore gets 3 points. I'll tell you what it is. So, this nodule, as you can see, the vertical height or the AP height, AP diameter is larger than the transverse. So, it is a suspicious observation. Apart from that, it is hypoechoic. It has these specks of calcification and the margins are not regular. It is ill-defined. Okay, I'm coming to this margin thing. So, smooth margin is a benign finding. So, ill-defined or lobulated or irregular. Outline is a suspicious feature. Can you all hear and can you all understand?
Yes, sir.
Right. So, the margin of this nodule is entirely very, so it is a feature of a benign nodule. Then this one, see, it has a lobulated outline. It's like lobules, and this area is ill defined. So these are suspicious features. Again, lobulated as well as irregular outline, suspicious feature. Then comes to calcifications. So there are various types of calcifications. When you see large calcifications like this, these are features of benign nodules. You don't get large or dystrophic calcifications in a malignant lesion. Usually you get micro or punctate calcifications. So larger the calcification, more towards benign. So these are, again, large calcifications. But, okay. The rim calcification is borderline finding. When you see rim calcification, it can be seen in both benign nodules as well as malignant nodules. See, the calcifications are seen in the rim or the margin. When it comes to micro calcifications, that is the suspicious feature. See, this lesion. All the features are towards a malignancy. Why is that? The margins are irregular and lobulated. The vertical height is more than the transverse height. And it is hypoechoic. Hypoechoic lesions are more suspicious than hypoechoic nodules. Above all, it has tiny hyperechoic foci. These are microcalcifications. So calcium is hyperechoic because ultrasound won't traverse through that particular point. So that's why you see it as more white or more bright spots. So that is, you call it hyperechoic foci. Okay. The growth is not directly comes into this classification, but when you see rapid interval change, again, you need to do further evaluation because rapid growth or interval size increment is a suspicious feature. Right. Now, in our routine practice, we see a lot of multinodular goiters. Okay. But in multinodular goiters, we don't do sampling or get measurements for all the nodules. We go for two main lesions, either by the size or the appearance. Okay, by classification, we get we narrow down into two nodules and we evaluate them. Like if when we are doing FNAC, we don't do FNAC from all the nodules. We go for most suspicious two nodules. Okay, these are a few examples. Okay, can someone tell me whether it's perfectly all right to make any mistake? Just describe this lesion. It's in the left lobe.
Sir, it's a there is a isoechoic lesion with multiple hypoechoic area. So it could be a mixed type of yes. nodule, and yes. the it's wider than it's more wider than the height, the tallness, and the margins are quite irregular on the lateral side, left side, but the other areas are smooth.
So overall, you're describing the features of benign nodule.
Yes.
Huh? Yeah. Almost. Nodule. Yes. So isoechoic. Mixed solid and cystic areas. There is no suspicious, you know, vertical height. Then there are no punctate calcifications or calcific foci. This could be a small calcification. So overall, it carries marks. Finally, it will be categorized in TI-RADS 3, in my opinion. That means probably benign. Huh? So they have classified it as TI-RADS 2 run. So composition is mixed. It's a benign finding. Echogenicity is iso, like you correctly said. Shape, margin, and echogenic foci all get negative marks. That means they are benign finding. So overall, this is more towards a benign nodule. Okay. Now this one, it's more cystic. And like lace-like pattern. So this is more towards that spongiform thing. Huh? And more cystic areas. Again, smooth wall. No calcifications. So it is again either TI-RADS 2 or 3 nodule. More towards TI-RADS 2. This one is compared to the surrounding parenchyma isoechoic. And it has more solid areas, but there are cystic areas with lace-like pattern. So composition is predominantly solid. So it gets two marks. Echogenicity is iso. It gets one mark. Shape is fine. It is rounded and well-defined. Margins are well-defined. No calcifications. So it carries intermediate here. Points. So finally, it will come as TI-RADS 3. That means probably benign category. Well defined, predominantly solid, isoechoic, no punctate calcifications. Another example of TI-RADS 3, or rather, probably benign nodule. Okay, now this one, it has a suspicious feature out of the most of the nodule, the features are in towards the benign side, but there's a suspicious feature. Can you tell me what it is?
ill-defined margins?
Okay, it's not really ill-defined because, see that, now, overall it has a smooth outline. But it is hypoechoic compared to this compressed surrounding parenchyma. See, it is hypoechoic. So, like I said earlier, this echogenicity. Hypoechoic is more in favor of malignancy, malignant side. Hyperechoic or more white is towards benign. But all the other features are towards the benign side. So, composition is solid, it gets 2 marks. Echogenicity, hypo, like I said, so it carries more marks. But the shape, margin, no calcifications, all get 0 marks. But due to this hypoechoic nature and solid composition, it will be categorized in 4. But if I subcategorize this nodule, I would say this is a low suspicion or TI-RADS 4A nodule. So, but it needs FNAC. Okay. Right. Another one can describe this.
There is a hypoechoic nodule with the high AP diameter and the transverse diameter and regular margin, and there is spongiform area.
Yes.
So the AP diameter is high, which is more suspicious.
Yes, that is very much suspicious, and it is very hypoechoic. See, very, very much hypoechoic compared to the hyperechoic thyroid, the rest of the parenchyma. I would say the margins are regular here, but slightly irregular in this aspect, but no calcification, but it is entirely solid. Okay. So, vascularity is another finding, but it doesn't come into that classification. But when you say internal vascularity, it is an inconclusive finding because you see vascularity in both benign lesions as well as malignant lesions. Okay. So finally, it will get marks like this. Composition is solid, so it gets highest marks. Echogenicity, hypoechoic, highest marks. The shape, like you correctly said, the vertical height is more, so the shape is very suspicious. But like I said, margins are regular and no calcifications, but overall it gets more points, so it will be categorized under TI-RADS 5. That is until proven otherwise it is malignant, so FNAC is mandatory. Okay. Right. Another example, composition is solid, echogenicity is hypo, so all gets high marks, but shape is regular, margin smooth, 0, no calcifications, TI-RADS 4. So TI-RADS 4 is again have to do FNAC. Another suspicious nodule, slightly lobulated and ill-defined, hypoechoic, solid, punctate calcifications. See, punctate means foci, multiple foci of calcifications. You call it punctate. So all gets high marks, and it will be categorized in TI-RADS 5. So it is until proven otherwise a malignant lesion. When we do FNAC, if it comes negative, we have to repeat. You can't just ignore a negative FNAC result with this ultrasound finding won't exclude a malignancy. So you need to repeat it. Remember that. Okay. Right. That will that concludes the pictures and the presentation. And can someone tell me the preparation for FNAC? Then, would have been balanced the acne,
huh? No preparation.
Yes, there is no preparation. Right?
So if NAC, like I said, and it's a superficial structure. So thyroid, breast, or any other soft tissues, there will be no preparation, no blood investigations, no fasting, nothing. Okay. In breast, even true cut or lymph node true cut, you don't prepare the patient unless there are diagnosed errors in coagulopathy, like cirrhotic patients, non-cirrhotic patients, or non-coagulopathies. Then you will do the coagulopathy screening just in order to just to prevent bleeding. But otherwise, there will be no preparation. Okay. All right. Then any questions?
Sir, when is, like, if NAC usually indicated, is it above TI-RADS 3?
Yes.
So, 3 and above?
Yes. Okay. 3, like I said, the risk of malignancy is less than 5%. So, either you can observe or you can straight away go for FNAC and exclude.
Okay. Right.
That's 1 and 2, like cyst and that spongiform, the purely spongiform appearance. You don't have to do anything because invariably they will be negative.
Okay.
This one, just spongiform nodule. You will not gain anything apart from that. The fluid, so these observations you can monitor, or you actually you can ignore. If someone asks whether what's your surveillance management, you can say long term follow up, or you can just ignore the lesion. Both will be correct. Any sir? Other questions? Yeah.
If the patient present with thyroid nodule and lymph node enlargement, how do we identify the reactive nodule and the pathological lymph nodes?
Good question. Yes. You know the normal morphology of the lymph node. It is a bean-shaped or rather oval. And it has a fatty hilum. That fatty hilum has a pedicle which gives the blood vessels. Harini? Anyone there?
Yes.
Okay. The suspicious nodules, they are more rounded with loss of fatty hilum. So that normal architecture will be lost. The fatty hilum you will not see, and it will be not oval in shape. And the size, the most accurate criteria is the size. You go by the size. Anything more than 10 millimeter, the short axis diameter is suspicious. Having said that, these two, jugulodigastic lymph nodes, this level 2 deep cervical nodes are usually prominent when I can palpate my both level 2 nodes. So they are the size, even these prominent nodules we can ignore if the nodules are, like I said, oval shaped with preserved fatty hilum, right? But any other deep cervical groups, 3, 4, 2, 3, pain on either?
Yes, sir.
2, 3, 4. 4 is the level 4, that is supraclavicular. And 1, submental. So these are submental, then comes 4, 5 and posterior neck nodes. Make ohari ahuno, they are suspicious. Metana, not really suspicious unless the short axis diameter is more than 10 and rounded in nature with loss of fatty acid. Again, the inguinal nodes. Inguinal nodes are available to you. May samarai gahuin. Because low limb swelling in the authentic, and some inguinal nodes slightly prominent. But anything, you know, abnormally large with other monkey findings, you know, they were suspicious. If any hurry to cut karna kota api, inguinal nodes avoid karna. Inguinal nodes negative anything chance very even in a malignant patient. A normal drainage system. Sir, when a query in a tantama, you got an outselling gun. Take a mother, dear.
Thank you, sir.
Come on, any more questions? Lymph node swelling, you can do both aphenesia as well as true cut, depending on the size and the location.
Sir, if the ultrasound and aphenesia is suggestive of malignancy and true cut biopsy is negative, can it be happen?
Yes. අපි sample එක කවුද අපි sample වෙන තැනින් ගත්තත් හරි ඒ ගත්ත තැන malignant cells represent කරන්නේ නැත්නම් it can be negative නේ but radiologically if the lesions are suspicious both in breast and thyroid you need to repeat or you can go for excision biopsy breast එකේ excision biopsy එකට යන්න පුළුවන් but thyroid එකේ excision biopsy යන්න බැහැ නේ you excision biopsy කියලා ගන්න thyroid වල එතකොට you need to discuss and come to a conclusion and sometimes you may need to remove that part also.
Thank you sir.
Pinadu for the udama lines එකේ තියෙන bean shape
yes sir.
Oh bean shape oval shape අර hypoechoic hilum එක තමයි අර තියෙන මගේ fatty hilum this one
yes
so the architecture ka wenas wenawa the lesion the node will be more rounded with lots of fatty hilum and like in papillary CA calcification is a feature ne so the lymph nodes la calcification sena ha tamuk nattan athi neda කවදද මේ අපොයින්ට්මන්ට් එක ඉවරන්නේ